Well, garden guru time. And today our garden guru is a palmist. Please meet Frank Clifford. And to show us what he does, we've got the loveliest hands in the house today. And they belong to the, and I mean glamorous, Lisa from Big Brother. Look at these mitts. Look at these mitts. Lisa, I think it's outrageous that Cardiff is our top town. That's where you're from.
Exactly, and we've got the Red Dragon people there, and I was talking to you earlier about all the people in the Brasserie right behind the show.
And so our friends really at Red Dragon and the Brasserie and all over Cardiff. Yeah, oh, shmey butty. It's nice to have them. Yeah, the duck.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly, but they all love us here.
Well, I'm so thrilled you're here, and you are looking gorgeous. Do you watch Family Affairs, Soap?
Now and then.
You look like that wonderful woman, Kasia Polker, I think her name is, who plays Gary Webster's wife in it.
Right, I'll have
Oh, but you look fabulous. What have you had done to change yourself then?
My nose.
Oh, have you? What was wrong with it before?
It was hooked.
Was it hooked?
Yes, apparently.
Oh, darling, but it's not now.
Thank
it's
you,
lovely.
Sweetheart. Thank you very much.
Frank, I've not been ignoring you, darling.
It's okay, Russell.
Oh, and I've got your chart here. We won't do that. We'll do that in a minute. You're an Aries.
I am, yes.
Because you look a little bit that way.
I do, yes.
And I think as a palmist, you rather like these palms, don't you, Lisa?
I do. They're 100% feminine and very beautiful, yes. But I'm going to tell you a bit about palmistry and what
Lovely.
I do.
Can I ask you, first of all, then, you've got not Lisa's hands here.
No, no, that's not Lisa's
hands. We want to make it clear these are not Lisa's hands. These are a Navi's hands, who I met, because he was doing the road, you understand, just outside here in Soho. He didn't charge us a penny for these hands. And what do we find here?
Well, when we look at a hand, we look at the fingers, the fingerprints, the main lines. You look at the left hand to understand the real person, the psychological side of them, who they are in private. And you look at their right hand to see who they are in public, who they present themselves
So tell us, tell us a little about the lines.
Oh, we've got the lifeline here that comes round, this here. Now this doesn't tell you the length of your life, because people get worried about having a short lifeline. It tells you more about the quality of your life, how enthusiastic, how much energy you have, and also how persevering you are in your life. The headline is the one that cuts across the hand here, and that tells you about your mental approach. For example, a short headline would say that you make decisions very quickly, a bit rash and impulsive. A longer one, which is quite long here, we'd look at, it would tell you how that they were very indecisive and really need to mull things over. Then we've got the heart line that comes up here. This tells you about your emotional responses, how you are in relationship to what you expect. A curved one will tell you somebody who's very passionate and warm and demonstrative. A straight one will tell you that they like to think about things, they need gifts.
Do they change with age as we get
they
older?
They do, they develop over the years as we make decisions. The hands reflect the changes we make in our lives. It's all
do
about
they tell the future?
They do, they can
they do.
Do, but it's negotiable.
Would you like to have a Vada at
I will, now,
her bona mitts?
What I do, and something I do in my book, Palmistry for Today, is to shake the hand. It's called the party piece.
If you can point yourself towards there, darling, point yourself towards Cardiff.
It's called the party piece. You shake your hand and you put your hands down. And we look very easily, anybody can do this at home, we look at where the palm, the fingers are in relation to each other. So if the thumb is rather stuck out in the hand here, somebody who tells you their life story at the drop of a hat. If it's more in as it is in this hand, it really tells you that you're very private, you have one or two close friends, and the rest of the people think they know you, but it's really by invitation only.
Hang on.
When we look at these two fingers here, we've got somebody asserting themselves when the index finger sticks out here. When they're close together, these, not so close together in your hand, but when they are, it's somebody who plays a bit of a martyr looking after everyone. But the key here in the hand is the little finger. It rules all the good stuff. Love, sex, communication, all the good stuff.
Isn't that the Mercury finger?
That is the Mercury finger. Mm. Now, when it sticks out like this, it means that if you're in a relationship, you need your space. It means that you need time away from everyone, a day off somewhere, just to have your own life.
Absolutely.
You should live next door and visit occasionally with that sort of marking.
Do you know, lovely. You're absolutely spot on. Right. Spot on. Fantastic.
Did you understand what was being told you there?
Yeah. It's I was absolutely brilliant. Really, really good. Absolutely.
And there's more to come a bit later. Yes.
Oh, yes. Well, if you take your palm.
Fascinating. I actually stick that little finger out when I drink as well.
Oh, is that a good sign?
Yes. So, well, yes, it's a feminine sign, isn't it? Very delicate.
Oh, I don't understand why I do it then. Anyway, thanks ever so much, Frank.
You're welcome.
It's been good to have you on.